Good morning, Weatherford. This is the Master Builder Show, sponsored by the First National Bank of Weatherford. I'm your host, Jim Gibson, president of Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, a registered builder in the state of Texas and a graduate master builder certified by the National Association of Home Builders. Today's topic is going to be appliances and energy-efficient appliances. My guests today are Al Bowen, he's Senior Contract Account Manager for the Whirlpool Corporation, and Jean Gibson, Vice President of Gibson Home Builders Incorporated. She's also my wife and usually has a lot to say. But anyway.
Sets me up every time.
How are you this morning, Al?
Very good, Jim.
All right. We're going to talk about appliances today. If any of you listeners have any questions for us, you can call us on 877-341-8950. That's 877-341-8950. If you need to check out a builder or a remodeler, you can go to www.masterbuildershow.com. It'll take you into my homepage or my website, and you can click on TRCC, which is the Texas Residential Construction Commission, and you can check and make sure that a builder is registered and a remodeler is registered, and a remodeler is required now to be registered if he's doing any jobs that are cost more than $10,000. Anyway, what are we doing?
What? I get a minute.
Okay.
I get a minute first.
All right.
But casa for casa.
All right.
Okay. We're building. Seven builders in the Weatherford area are building playhouses that will be, I can't say auctioned off, but
raffled off.
Okay. For the benefit of CASA, court-appointed special advocate program for here in the Weatherford area. And we're getting down to the deadline, sir, right. And you've got a castle to build.
I know.
You better get it in gear.
The
playhouses will be at the Super Save grocery store parking lot. Our little village will be set up out there from April 12th to the 25th, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. every day. It's going to be open up so that people can come on out and the children can check out the playhouses and buy their chance to get a house. And the drawing and the prizes, they're going to have drawings in those children. I wonder if they have to pick them up on the day of the drawing.
Are they going to do like they did last year and have the people put the tickets in each house that they're wanting to win?
I think that's how they had planned to do it. So Okay. You actually buy a chance for a specific house. And the drawings are on Saturday, April the 26th from 11 to 1. So during that time frame, there's going to be music and food, and they're planning a lot of activities and have a fair-like opportunity for the kids to come on out, and they run through all the playhouses and check them out and pick out their favorite one.
Well, we had a band there last year, too.
Yeah, there's music planned for this year again.
Okay, great.
So it's a big to-do for here in Weatherford.
Who sponsors this?
Well, it's the seven individual builders who are doing this for CASA.
And we're trying, go out and try to get our own sponsors to help offset the cost of building. I think I had $3,000 in my house last year.
Mm-hmm.
And we had donated, I had a lot of labor donated too last year. I ended up paying for a lot of materials, but this year I'm getting most of the materials donated, and the labor is the problem.
You're going to do it, and I'm going to watch.
I know.
And so this year we had to submit drawings in advance, and I think they're already up on the CASA or about to be up on the CASA website, so you can preview the houses. And last year Jim built a cluster of mushrooms, and this year he's building a castle. And I want a dragon in the window, and so we still haven't agreed on that happening. So anyway.
I don't know how to build a dragon.
That's CASA for CASA, and the drawings will be April 26th from 11 to 1.
All right. Now let's get down to our main topic here.
Yeah.
Today we're going to talk about appliances. And if you live in a typical U.S. home, which most of us do, our appliances in our home are responsible for about 20% of energy used in a home. And we're talking about refrigerators, freezers, clothes washers, dryers, dishwashers, and ranges, ovens, which everybody has and everybody uses. And so it's important now, especially with energy costs the way they're rising, for us to, when you replace an appliance, to go out and check out the Energy Star appliances. And Al, what are we going to talk about today? We brought you in here. You're with the Whirlpool Corporation. And on your energy efficient appliances now, let's talk about just say refrigerators. What makes them more energy efficient than the older refrigerators?
Well, a lot of technology has has evolved over the years in appliances and refrigerators as well as everything else. New adaptive defrost systems, new insulation. The refrigerators maintain temperatures a lot better than they used to, and compressors and everything use a lot less energy. They don't run as much.
What's a good temperature for you to keep your refrigerator in your freezer?
Refrigerator needs to be somewhere around 37, 38 degrees, and a freezer ideally around zero.
Okay. And you want to try to maintain that constant?
Yes.
All right, let's talk. You're saying the compressors are better. We're using different types of Freon now, too, aren't we?
Yes, we are. The old R12s and the old
R22s.
R22s, they've been replaced by a lot more environmentally friendly refrigerants that don't affect the ozone like the old, as we kind of used to refer to them as Freons.
Right. What's the difference in and I noticed they're your commercial grade type refrigerators and stuff like that, they're made to go in and out every 15, 20 minutes, so they recoup faster, don't they?
Right.
What are we talking about? They go in and out of what?
Well, if
the compressor kicks on?
No. If you're a cook and you're cooking a restaurant and you're cooking eggs for somebody, you're going in and out of that refrigerator constantly.
Oh, I see.
And so you want your recovery time to come back on your refrigerator faster. I mean, as fast as it can, because if you're going in and out, if it didn't, then it would warm up so much that it or cost you a fortune. But that's primarily what you're paying for when you're buying one, isn't it?
Right, yeah. That's correct.
Recovery time?
And, you know, you want to remove the heat from the food as quickly as possible when you put something in the refrigerator. Of course, every time you open a door, you lose cold air. Refrigerators today, we have a lot of Energy Star models that have variable speed compressors on them. So as less cooling is needed, the compressor slows down. Then when you've opened the door, loaded food into the refrigerator, it speeds up. And so the compressor actually runs faster once once the refrigerator, the sensors are calling for cooling.
Oh, it's kind of like we put in a lot of variable speed air handlers now.
Correct.
So what we're doing is if it demands it, it jumps in there, cools it down, then it goes into an idle kind of speed.
Correct.
So the compressors are doing the same thing in refrigerators.
That's correct.
Wow.
Well, what's the real difference? You buy a refrigerator, once every 20 years? I mean, they just don't break down. So what's the difference with the Energy Star? What am I saving? They give me numbers, but it really... How does it equate to dollar for dollar a usage?
We're going to go through that when we come back. We've got a break. We'll be back in a couple of minutes.
Did you know that some of the best home builders in the entire nation are right here in Parker County? Hello, everyone. This is Lynn Bearden, president of First National Bank of Weatherford. Our lenders believe your family deserves the best when it comes to your dream home. First National Bank is proud to support the Master Builder Show on QXFM. First National Bank in Weatherford has been building homes in Parker County since 1880. Member, FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
YourCircleOfWealth.com. A recent study by one of the world's largest financial institutions estimates that over 90% of baby boomers will not retire financially independent. We have prepared a financial report entitled Your Circle of Wealth. Learn how changing the way you manage your money can dramatically increase your wealth. To get a copy, you may go to www.yourcircleofwealth.com and enter the passcode Gibson, G-I-B-S-O-N. That's yourcirclesofwealth.com.
Fort Worth Lighting, serving the building professional in Parker, Wise, Palo Pinto, and surrounding counties. Services include planned takeoff, site walkthrough, and delivery. For an appointment with a Fort Worth Lighting consultant, the number is 817-597-6320, or the website is fortworthlighting.com. Again, it's 817-597-6320 for Fort Worth Lighting.
North Texas Basements, 817-770-2768. With over 30 years of experience in residential construction, add extra living area, storm protection, and extra room that will be easy to heat and cool without needing a large piece of ground to build on. Think about having a basement in your next home. North Texas Basements, 817-770-BSMT or 817-770-2768. Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, 2401 Zion Hill Road, Weatherford, Texas, 682-429-2116. We specialize in homes to suit each and every individual that expects special attention. We help design, finance, and close on every home we build. We use green building techniques in all of our homes. You can contact Jim at masterbuildershow.com. Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, Weatherford, 682-429-2116. Welcome back to the Master Builder Show. I'm your host, Jim Gibson. Today's show is sponsored by the First National Bank of Weatherford. My guests today are Al Bowen. He's with the Whirlpool Corporation. My wife, Jean Gibson, with Gibson Home Builders. We're talking about appliances and Energy Star appliances is what she was asking. What makes it an Energy Star appliance? What makes it an Energy Star appliance?
Uses less energy.
Less energy. Normally,
define less energy.
Less
for
energy.
Me.
All appliances now have a standard that's set by the Department of Energy that they have to meet to be manufactured. They're manufactured guidelines. And Energy Star is a rating given to those units that are, I think the, it's in a percentage. I think it's 30%, or not 30, it's 20% better than those standards. So you
so
got,
what was, what's, how, what standard is my 20-year-old refrigerator hitting?
It's not hitting a standard. It's an energy hog.
Yeah, it's eating up energy, and it probably cost you 20 to 30% more running that unit than it would if you went down and replaced it and bought it.
Probably more
unit.
Than that.
Yeah,
25 cubic foot side by side refrigerators today use less energy than a 100-watt light bulb.
Wow.
And, oh, I just got a good excuse.
Yeah, to buy a new refrigerator. Well, really, they'll pay for it themselves.
Well,
you know, it really, if you've got an
I'll
old
explain
one,
that to the salesman.
And it's a trickle down effect too. You know, you don't think about the energy that you're using on your current refrigerator, mm-mm. but the electric company is having to generate that, which is causing greenhouse gases.
Mm-hmm.
And the way to tell an Energy Star appliance is that they've got a tag, and it's usually a yellow tag, and it will tell you on that tag how energy efficient that unit is.
Yeah, but I don't have a point of comparison with my antique.
Well, you do, but the only way you can compare it would be with your electric bill.
Which is horrific lately. Also, yeah. I asked you, who is Whirlpool?
Yeah,
and you know, what products fall under Whirlpool?
Well, the Whirlpool Corporation, we market the Whirlpool brand, the KitchenAid brand, the Maytag brand, the Genair brand, and the Amana brand.
Oh, my.
So when you buy a Whirlpool, you're buying any of those, you're buying a Whirlpool product.
It's a Whirlpool Corporation product, yes.
Is there a common mechanical base to all of them?
No.
Are they manufactured in the same plants and labeled?
Not always. Some are manufactured in the same plant, but like our dishwashers, we have three different dishwasher plants that our dishwashers come out of.
Are they all American made?
All of our dishwashers are American made.
What about the other appliances?
We have plants all over the world. Coming into the United States, we have a refrigerator and a range plant in Mexico. That some of our products come in from. Of course, our microwave ovens come from China.
All right.
And Sweden. We have a large microwave oven plant in Sweden.
Okay.
The standards are, there's a different criteria that my understanding from some readings was that the criteria for appliances, power utilization, water utilization and all, were more strict in Europe. Than
yes,
they are here.
Very strict in Europe.
So the appliances are dumbed down for us? They use more electricity?
Yes, they do. I mean, in Europe, you do not find a lot of 25 cubic foot side-by-side refrigerators. They will have 6, 8, 10 cubic foot refrigerators. They go to the grocery store almost every day. Their laundry is all very compact, all front load.
They've got, in their washers, they've got heating units. You just run cold water to the unit itself,
we offer those in the U.S. as well.
Okay,
and is that a major market? Is the United States responding?
Our front load laundry and our top load E-Star energy efficient products are very rapidly approaching becoming our largest selling laundry products.
Well, the main thing about the washers is they use anywhere from 30 to 50% less water on each load, and
right.
They about 30 to 40% less energy.
A typical top load washer uses about 45 gallons of water.
During a cycle.
I didn't realize it so much.
And a typical front load high efficiency can use as little as 10.
Yeah, and if you just use 40 gallons per load, a typical household used about 7,000 gallons a year just washing clothes, and that's a lot of water.
Listening to the ads, though, you kind of get the feeling that those front loaders are not getting the clothes as clean.
Well, no, I think that's a myth. I think they get them clean. You've got what makes them more efficient. One of the things is their spin cycles. When they finally at the end there, their spin cycles are much faster, so the clothes come out much drier. And when they go into the dryer unit, the dryer doesn't have to work as long or as hard to dry your clothes.
That's correct. Mm. And commercial laundries have used front-load laundry for years and years.
So we're getting more like a commercial brand. I mean, the reason they were commercial used because they were more energy efficient. You know, mm-hmm. saved the laundromat some money, I would think, too.
And the front-load, these high-efficiency front-loads, you can put more clothes into them for a cycle. Like, you know, you can wash 16 pairs of jeans in a full-size front load.
But I'd have to stand there naked while I was doing it.
Excuse me. That's a bad sign. Anyway, Energy Card, when you're choosing, how would a person go about choosing a washer? I mean, you need to choose it for your size.
You need to match what you're purchasing to your needs and your family.
All right, yeah, because washers come in, about 1.6 cubic feet up to about 3 cubic foot?
About 3.5.
About 3. So they've got some huge machines out there.
Yes, they do.
So, like, if you've got two or three kids running around the house, you want to go ahead and get the biggest so you don't have to wash over and over and over.
Over and over.
And you've got dryers to match those units,
yes.
too. So, wow.
And laundry is something I don't think anyone enjoys doing.
Right.
I know my wife wants to, you know, she wants to get in, get the laundry done, get out, and go do something that's fun.
I remember mm-hmm. back years ago when we didn't have a washer or too poor to buy a washer and dryer, you know, and you had to go to the laundromat and you'd go out there and do like 7 to 10 loads. You'd save your clothes all week, and it would take you several hours, you know, at the laundromat.
You had the laundromat. I thought maybe you had the rock.
Yeah, well. I thought you were the same age as I was.
Yeah.
Well, I'm accused of being older than dirt. So.
What about dishwashers?
Same effect. Criteria for Energy Star is on dishwashers as well.
They've got all sorts of different types. That, you know, instead of the old standard type of dishwashers where you pull the door open and slide out the trays, they've got top-loading dishwashers now. They've got
They've always had those, haven't they? The small ones that, remember, we looked at them for our RV.
Yeah.
We put a...
In the drawers?
Yeah. They had some smaller ones that... And I think on those multi-drawer ones, you can get them that do independent cycles.
Yes, you can. You can put pots and pans in the bottom one and put your good china in the top one. And
they run individually.
Yes, they run individually. The nice thing about that, you know, if there's just two of you,
uh-huh.
You know, you don't feel guilty after 3 days that dishwasher set there with a half a load and you run it with just a half a load.
And you can run one drawer at a time, too, can't you?
That's what's so appealing.
Yeah.
And
that's what my mom said. She takes a whole week to fill up the dishwasher, and she won't run it before then.
Well, did they hold the same capacity as a regular dishwasher? I mean,
when you get to both drawers, yes.
So,
and you can have one drawer of dirties and one drawer of cleans.
So for a couple living, that would be perfect
for
a couple.
Yeah.
And that way, when you had company, you could use the whole thing.
Well, it's on some of the newer technologies. I mean, are they getting away from soap and water for cleaning into something, you know, laser, a scanner?
We're not seeing any of that in any kind of a mass. There's some prototypes that
What do they do?
Sandblasters.
That's good for the gold trim on your dishes.
Right.
I just know that technology is progressing in that area. I haven't really seen anything yet.
And so what's some of the new things that are out on the market that somebody like me, could find and add to my home. The drawers are new.
The drawers, they've been around a few years. Some of the new drawers, our new drawer line, of course, there's a single drawer. And one nice thing about the drawers, you don't have to bend over.
We've got to take a break. We'll be back here in just a couple of minutes.
Did you know that some of the best home builders in the entire nation are right here in Parker County? Hello, everyone. This is Lynn Bearden, president of First National Bank of Weatherford. Our lenders believe your family deserves the best when it comes to your dream home. First National Bank is proud to support the Master Builder Show on QXFM. First National Bank in Weatherford has been building homes in Parker County since 1880. Member, FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Are you having a construction-related issue? Do you need a construction attorney? If so, you may call the law firm of Kelly M. Davis and Associates. Kelly's family background in the construction industry has led to her focus in construction litigation. With over 9 years of experience practicing construction law in and around the metro area. For more information, you may visit www.kmdalegal.com or you may call 972-434-8009. That's 972-434-8009.
Alamo Appliance, 100 South Riverside Drive in Fort Worth, has been dedicated to serving your needs in kitchen appliances for over 35 years. They offer Jennair, KitchenAid, Whirlpool, Maytag, Amana, and many others. Their experienced sales staff will help you make the right decisions at the right time. That's Alamo Appliance, 817-531-2701. Once again, that's Alamo Appliance, 817-531-2701.
Fort Worth Lighting, serving the building professional in Parker, Wise, Palo Pinto, and surrounding counties. Services include planned takeoff, site walkthrough, and delivery. For an appointment with a Fort Worth Lighting consultant, the number is 817-597-6320, or the website is fortworthlighting.com. Again, it's 817-597-6320 for Fort Worth Lighting.
I'm Jean Gibson, and I love Weatherford, and I'm proud to offer Zion Hill Estates. Zion Hill Estates is a country development 5 minutes from the center of Weatherford, grocery stores, hospitals, banks, department stores, and in the Pister School District. 1 acre lot minimums gives you space to spread your arms and enjoy country living. 2 or more acres will give you space for your horse or your goats. Gibson Home Builders, 682-429-2116, will build you the home of your dreams in Zion Hill Estates. Go north of the square to 920, left on Zion Hill Road for 2.4 miles to Zion Hill Estates. We'd like to show you the land and an energy-efficient model home. The number is 682-429-2116.
Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, 2401 Zion Hill Road, Weatherford, Texas, 682-429-2116. We specialize in homes to suit each and every individual that expects special attention. We help design, finance, and close on every home we build. We use green building techniques in all of our homes. You can contact Jim at masterbuildershow.com. Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, Weatherford, 682-429-2116. Welcome back to the Master Builder Show. I am your host, Jim Gibson. Today's show is sponsored by the First National Bank of Weatherford. My guests today are Al Bowen with the Whirlpool Corporation, my wife, Jean Gibson with Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, and my wife. Anyway, we're talking about appliances, and primarily Energy Star appliances. The whole world now is going green, and we want to. It helps our budget. It helps our environment. So we were talking about drawer-type dishwashers, and Al, you said y'all had just opened up a new whole line of those drawer-type dishwashers.
We have a brand-new facility in Jackson, Tennessee that our brand-new line of dish drawers is coming out of this new facility. And in fact, they started on March 14th, so they are brand-new.
How do they compare in price to the standard type?
They're more.
Well, I figured it more.
Drawer by drawer as a two-drawer unit? they're more.
A two-drawer unit is going to be more than what a just conventional dishwasher is.
What kind of options did they come out with in this new line?
They have a new power wash bar across the back so that if you have, say, a casserole dish or something, you can face this really dirty item towards this power wash bar, and it concentrates, cycles on and off, and concentrates your wash energy into this particular dish across the rear.
They all have garbage disposals in them?
No. No. None of your European-branded models have garbage disposals in them. Most of the American-branded models do.
So they'll actually grind up the food so you don't
have to... They'll actually grind up the food so you don't have the filters to clean. You don't have to wash your dishes before you put them in the dishwasher.
Yeah, I always thought that with my mother. She'll go out and she'll wash every dish, and she'll use soap and then stick them in the dishwasher. She just wanted to make sure that she didn't get her dishwasher dirty. And that's all you thought. That was kind of odd.
Well, I'm looking for the latest and greatest in technologies, and so that's what I'm looking to you for. Tell me, what's the latest and greatest out there? Obviously, the drawers.
The drawers and some of our adaptive wash technology with sensors that will automatically determine how dirty your dishes are, how full a load you have in the dishwasher, and which that will determine what cycle, how long, what kind of water heating we need, if any.
And it turns itself on?
Not quite. You have to push the button.
But it senses everything, so it knows the wash cycle, what
yes.
wash cycle to run.
Yes. And during the first 60 seconds, it will determine how dirty the dishes are.
Holy cow.
And we'll take everything from there so that when the cycle is finished, if you only needed a light wash cycle, mm-hmm. If there was pre-rinsing done, or if you do like I do, they go in the dishwasher pretty dirty.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm not washing that twice.
I'm not washing it. I mean, I'm not going to put it in the dishwasher if I got to
wash it. How sanitary and how clean are they?
Very. The main wash cycle is going to reach 140 degrees. If you have the water heating cycle turned on or if you're using the adaptive wash cycle.
Most bacteria was washed away.
Is washed away. And
but it's not killing anything. It's loosening materials and washing away.
Right. It's going to get the dishes a lot more sanitary than you can wash in the sink because 10 degrees is about as hot as you can stand.
Mm-hmm.
At the sink. Plus, most water heaters are turned down, so you don't get as hot of water at the sink. So we're going to take the water during the main wash to 140. Then when you get to the final rinse to help improve drying, we're going to take the water there to 145 degrees. So those dishes are going to be subjected to extended periods of a lot hotter water than you could do standing at the sink.
Do they have any, like, infrared technology or anything like that that they're
going to... That's part of the... Part of the sensor control, there's a turbidity light sensor.
What is okay? Turbidity means?
Turbidity, it's got a light. It's a form of a laser that goes through the water coming into the pump, and it measures and determines how dirty, how much soil and everything is going into the pump.
Wow.
Does the manufacturer ever culture the dishes when they come out? I'm thinking of a family full of flu patients. I mean, are we going to kill those flu bugs? And that's why, did the manufacturer ever culture them?
Yes, we do. And most of our models have a Sani cycle on them. And this is NSF approved, will kill 99.999% of all the bacteria if that cycle is selected.
And what's different in that cycle than the other regular
cycle? It extends the 140 degree main wash cycle, then at the very end, there is an extended rinse up to 165 degrees.
Wow. Yeah.
So that cycle is going to get very hot, and it runs for an extended period of time at that 165 degrees.
Do they have more than two drawers? Can you get three-drawer models, four-drawer models?
You can put them side by side, as many as you want. And the nice thing about some of these single drawers, especially if bending over is a problem,
right?
You can put a single drawer, one on either side of the sink. Then there's just virtually no bending.
Oh, yeah. So they don't just come in two-drawer models.
Correct.
You actually put both of them high. And
what about the plumbing underneath? How about the space underneath this drawer? Is that a usable drawer? Space underneath the...
Yes.
All you got is just a water hose and electrical.
Water hose and electrical.
That's coming in there. All right. You want to go to ovens now. What about ovens? What has come about in our ovens that has
steam?
Steam?
Steam.
We our steam Ultima oven. Line of ovens introduces steam during the baking or roasting cycle, which is the same thing that commercial restaurants have been using for years. If you're a bread baker, especially of like French breads, no more having to get the water bottle, opening the oven.
To make it crispy.
To make it crispy and constantly spritzing inside the oven, spraying the wall of the oven to create steam.
You
can poach in the oven, poach fish.
And you can steam vegetables in an oven.
Steam vegetables in the oven. In addition to the steam, you get the convection fan plus the regular heat. So if you're cooking at 300 degrees, you can add from a minimal amount to a lot of steam.
Yeah, I think we got our first convection oven when about
in Granbury,
and that was what 4, 5, 6, 7 years ago,
somewhere around there.
And I, that was the first convection we had ever had.
It was wonderful.
And so I do a lot of baking and stuff and cooking, and I'd click it on, and it would automatically, say set your oven for 350 degrees and all this stuff. When I hit the convection mode, it dropped at 25, and I was going, wow, that's kind of neat. Using less power.
Less power, saves time.
Right.
Yeah. And your new steam oven is a standard oven or convection oven?
Yes. We offer it in a built-in configuration, both a single, a double, and an oven micro combination. So you can use it as a regular oven, convection oven, or you can add steam to any one of the settings. We also have two commercial-style freestanding ranges, a 30 and a 36-inch, that both offer the steam option.
Wow.
What's the interior? If you're
porcelain.
Porcelain interior.
Oh, yeah. So we don't have a rust problem. We don't It must be awfully easy to clean, too, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
What about what are we talking about in price? We're talking double or triple?
Not really. It adds about 50%.
About 50%, so that's not really bad.
On the wall ovens and just a few hundred dollars on the freestanding range.
How much more energy efficient are our new models coming out, like convection ovens and
Convection ovens is going to definitely be a lot more energy efficient. Because you cook at a lower temperature, they cook faster, cook more evenly.
Right. And then what about the steam oven? Are they more energy efficient than a convection oven?
Well, you're going to have the convection operating during the steam on most cycles. So the steam is going to improve the quality of what's coming out.
So on your new ovens, you're going to run power to it and you're going to run a water line to it.
On the built-in wall ovens, yes. The freestanding ranges do not need a water line. They have a built-in water tank that you just pour water into. But the wall ovens, you run a water line to the oven.
Okay.
And it's a filtered water that even in some of our harder water areas, like Weatherford, this filter helps to soften the water, remove some of the minerals and prevent scaling and things of this nature.
So I need to point out, or really during my rough end now, I need to start asking my customer if he's going to have a steam oven.
And this water line needs to be in an adjacent cabinet. So it's accessible. You need to be able to turn the water off. You need to be able to reach the filter. The filter is probably about 3 inches in diameter and about a foot long.
So just mounted in an adjacent or underneath.
An adjacent cabinet.
And why do you have to turn it off?
To change the filter.
Oh, and that's all?
Right.
So there's no other... activity.
Or if you were removing the oven for any reason.
Can you put the filter like any height?
Any height.
So it's actually a separate unit that mounts somewhere outside.
Yes.
Does it have to be very close to it? It has to be adjacent?
It could be under the sink.
Okay.
If you wanted to run a water line from under the sink through your cabinet, you could put the water filter under the sink and just run a quarter-inch copper line.
It has to be copper?
Needs to be copper.
Yeah, I guess plastic would melt.
Good thinking.
We don't recommend plastic for anything that's going to carry water.
Well, we use anything that carries water. Well, you have a problem a lot of times down here, especially with calcium deposits. And
right.
They are, what do they call it, arterial action or where it, capillary action, where it shrinks. It builds
sclerosing.
Up stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. Hardening of the artery type.
Yes.
Copper type stuff. And
there's an educational curve, too, that goes on. Not being 21 anymore, I find that when I become accustomed to something, and then there are changes. I'm finding, talking to my peers, that they're not sure they even want to do convection ovens. But the equipment is so smart.
Yes.
Yeah.
As you said, ours was, and that's 6 or 7 years ago, it made the adjustment for us.
Right. It will do it. The steam is the same way. If you want manual control of the steam, if you're doing a creme brulee or something that needs a water bath, that you've got this recipe down.
You obviously cook.
I do. I love to cook, as you can tell. But the oven will allow you to do manual control of the steam.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you want to, to explore those options, or if you just want the benefit of the steam. You can select what you're doing. If you're baking or doing breads or proofing or doing meats, you just set the type of food you're doing. The oven will automatically determine whether it needs a minimal amount of steam or if it needs a lot of steam.
Yeah, this is not like the VCRs where the time changes, you have to bring the kids over to set it.
Yes.
They're everything.
Is he being mean to me? Wait a minute.
Everything now is kind of just turn it on. And
it has to be dumbed down.
And it automatically just takes care of itself, right?
Yes.
Well, that's a lot of what we were talking about when we first got together this morning, that we're all, the older of us, are reaching a computer limit, and you're just adding another computer to the household. They have to be smart.
Well, yeah. I mean,
that's all in a lot of appliances today are nothing but a computer extension. These steam ovens have an LCD screen, a touch screen on them, just like you find on a lot of computers.
Does it give you a menu?
Yes.
Okay, so if I want to do vegetables, I don't have to know any more than
vegetables and start.
You have to be able to read, though.
That's true. Yes. But every week he's been teaching his mother how to use her new cell phone because there's too many steps. So there really is a learning curve on all these new products.
Yes.
So the simpler they are,
nothing is simple anymore.
My mother, we had to put her in a rehab facility, and they didn't have phones in the room. And she had suffered a heart attack. And anyway, so we took her cell phone and said, here, Mom, flip it open to answer it and close it to, hang up. But she couldn't figure out how to call anybody because you actually dial the number and you pushed the green button, I think, on her. So
it was just too many steps.
Well, and we put everything on speed dial, but you had to go to the menu and you had to go to contact list and then you had to scroll down to the name you wanted and then you could hit the green button. But she couldn't get to the, well, she could get to the menu, but she'd forget what happened after that. She's 84. But
I think that's why she uses her new, absolutely gorgeous convection oven as a storage area for her pots and pans.
Mm-hmm.
It's too many steps.
Mm-hmm.
So it would be very impressive to see appliances that were smarter. Even that some of the dials on the refrigerators for ice and crushed ice and all that kind of stuff, the print is small.
Well, we've got to take another break. We'll be back here in a couple of minutes.
Did you know that some of the best home builders in the entire nation are right here in Parker County? Hello, everyone. This is Lynn Bearden, president of First National Bank of Weatherford. Our lenders believe your family deserves the best when it comes to your dream home. First National Bank is proud to support the Master Builder Show on QXFM. First National Bank in Weatherford has been building homes in Parker County since 1880. Member FDIC and an equal housing lender.
Are you having a construction-related issue? Do you need a construction attorney? If so, you may call the law firm of Kelly M. Davis & Associates. Kelly's background in the construction industry has led to her focus in construction litigation. With over 9 years of experience practicing construction law in and around the metro area. For more information, you may visit www.kmdalegal.com or you may call 972-434-8009. That's 972-434-8009. 434-8009.
Fort Worth Lighting, serving the building professional in Parker Wise, Palo Pinto, and surrounding counties. Services include planned takeoff, site walkthrough, and delivery. For an appointment with a Fort Worth Lighting consultant, the number is 817-597-6320, or the website is fortworthlighting.com. Again, it's 817-597-6320 for Fort Worth Lighting.
Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, 2401 Zion Hill Road, Weatherford, Texas, 682-429-2116. We specialize in homes to suit each and every individual that expects special attention. We help design, finance, and close on every home we build. We use green building techniques in all of our homes. You can contact Jim at masterbuildershow.com. Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, Weatherford, 682-429-2116. Welcome back to the Master Builder Show. I am your host, Jim Gibson. Today's show is sponsored by the First National Bank of Weatherford. My guests today are Al Bowen with Whirlpool Corporation, my wife, Jean Gibson, and we just had Gary Dollinger walk in the studio from Alamo Appliances.
Yeah, and he's going to be the guy that has to come up with all these things that I want to add.
Yeah, well,
I just asked, too, do you have any of these appliances that will talk to you?
Not yet.
But that would be one of the things in the works?
I'm sure that's going to be something in the works.
Yeah, would simplify
during
things.
During the break, I was asking about the smart appliances, too, where they could internet-based type appliances, and he said that we're not going that direction.
We're just reevaluating that.
Reevaluating
that area at the
moment. Was there a downside?
I think the number of units sold would probably be a downside.
Oh, okay.
I think if you get out there and start manufacturing these things, you don't just spit out one of them. You normally manufacture thousands, and they would have to sell 1,000 or 2,000 or 3,000 or a million. I don't guess. I mean, you're worldwide.
More than one.
You'd have to sell more than one. So you might have so many percentage of population out here, just like the building business. I don't have that. I don't have any people that have actually gone into a completely internet-based type house where you can go in and monitor your temperature, change your settings on your air conditioning system. Now, we got one.
One is close.
Yeah. One is real close, but he's still not totally automated. I mean, he can dial in or however he does it and check things out.
I still want to know about some more of the new whiz-bang stuff that's out there. Oh, you know what I noticed, too, that for a few years ago they came out with dry cleaning cabinets, so you washer and dryer, and I haven't seen those around. Are they passé now?
We have moved a lot of those into our new steam assist laundry, our new steam duet and steam cabrio, and in the Maytag, the steam Bravos and Epic. A lot of that takes place in the steam function of the dryer now. And
let's go on this subject quite a bit, because we didn't talk about the dryers having steam. We talked about the ovens having steam.
We have steam in dryers, in ovens, in ranges, and dishwashers.
Why would you steam the... way back on this one. All right, you've got a dryer. I can see throwing something in that's wrinkled or a final step to have it steamed so that it's smooth.
Correct. And by doing it in the dryer, you can we have steam in both the washer and the dryer. There's a lot of benefits to having it in a dryer because there's a lot of items that you wear once. Maybe you went out to eat and you come home and you smell like the restaurant.
Right.
Or it's just slightly wrinkled. Mm-hmm. It's not dirty. You only wore it a couple of hours, but it needs a refresh. You can put it in the dryer. I believe the cycle lasts about 15 minutes, and it introduces steam. So you get moisture to remove wrinkles, remove odors. Then you go into, by having the heat of the dryer, the clothes are dry when they come out, so you don't have to take them from after going through the steam cycle of the washer and put them into the dryer. So it does everything for you.
Is it a hanging cabinet or is it?
No,
the things are tumbled.
It's tumbled. It's a conventional dryer.
Because the old the old units or the first units that I ever saw with the dry cleaning.
Right.
You would hang things up.
You would hang things up.
And you don't do those anymore. No. It's not necessary.
No, it's not necessary.
But okay. You do have to be there to take them out.
Yeah.
Of course, it's going to buzz to let you know that, hey, I'm done.
Run. And why would I need steam in a washing machine?
Oh, stain removal. Grease-based stains are very hard to remove.
And steam will do it.
Steam will do it. Allergens, more so than water. The temperature of the steam will help remove more allergens than water alone.
Well, is the temperature of steam 212?
Because I would think it'd have to be.
It'd have to be hot enough
to where it would be boiling to produce steam.
I don't know what the it's going to be hot coming out of the of the steam nozzle.
So you have fabric limitations then. With a temperature increase, then you've got fabrics that won't tolerate that extreme temperature. But the fine fabrics. Plain old cotton.
I'm not sure it has to be boiling to get steam because actually when I did that show on hydrologic cycle about how evaporation starts, actually anything above freezing, water starts evaporating and it's not really turned to steam, but you do have fog, which is moisture in the air. And you've got convection fog, and you've got several different types of fog, but that's putting moisture in the air. Now, steam has, I guess it has a certain definition, though. It would have to be
a
certain speed of temperature, but I'm not sure that it's same temperature as boiling.
You just have to research that
I'll
and get back to us.
I'll have to research that. I didn't know we had so many steam-type machines.
Yeah, I had no idea.
The steam cycle does not actually bring the temperature of the clothes up to the 212 degree.
Okay.
I mean, they're gonna be a little warmer, but it's a fine mist, and as the steam buildup is increased in the washer or the dryer,
and then they're washed with water and soap after the fact.
Actually, the steam comes into play after the wash cycle.
Oh.
At the end of the cycle.
It's in the middle.
In the middle.
Mm-hmm. Unless you're doing it has to rinse out the particles that you're loosening.
Unless you're using the refresh cycle in the washer, and that's basically all you're going to get is steam.
Let's talk about cooktops. We haven't talked about cooktops yet. What is the latest
induction.
And greatest induction?
Induction.
All right. Tell me about induction.
Induction does not cook with heat. It cooks with magnetic energy.
Is that the one the pot sits on?
Yeah. Okay, we got to take another break. We'll be back here in a couple minutes.
Did you know that some of the best home builders in the entire nation are right here in Parker County? Hello, everyone. This is Lynn Bearden, president of First National Bank of Weatherford. Our lenders believe your family deserves the best when it comes to your dream home. First National Bank is proud to support the Master Builder Show on QXFM. First National Bank in Weatherford has been building homes in Parker County since 1880. Member, FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Are you having a construction-related issue? Do you need a construction attorney? If so, you may call the law firm of Kelly M. Davis and Associates. Kelly's family background in the construction industry has led to her focus in construction litigation with over 9 years of experience practicing construction law in and around the metro area. For more information, you may visit www.kmdalegal.com or you may call 972-434-8009. That's 972-434-8009.
I'm Jean Gibson, and I love Weatherford, and I'm proud to offer Zion Hill Estates. Zion Hill Estates is a country development 5 minutes from the center of Weatherford, grocery stores, hospitals, banks, department stores, and in the Pister School District. 1 acre lot minimums gives you space to spread your arms and enjoy country living. 2 or more acres will give you space for your horse or your goats. Gibson Home Builders, 682-429-2116, will build you the home of your dreams in Zion Hill Estates. Go north of the square to 920, left on Zion Hill Road for 2.4 miles to Zion Hill Estates. We'd like to show you the land and an energy-efficient model home. The number is 682-429-2116.
Welcome back to the Master Builder Show. I am your host, Jim Gibson. Today's show is sponsored by the First National Bank of Weatherford. My guests today are Al Bowen with the Whirlpool Corporation, my wife, Jean Gibson with Gibson Home Builders Incorporated, and Gary Dullinger with Alamo Appliances. All right, we were talking about the cooktops this time, and we were the newest and latest and greatest is the new induction type units right, right there. How do they work?
Induction cooktops cook with magnetic energy. Your cookware's got to be able to, a magnet's got to be able to stick on the side of it, and the heat's created by the magnetic induction of the cooktop creating heat.
And really, this has been around for a long time.
Been around for a long time.
This is an MRI.
Well, basically.
Well, magnetic resonance imaging
pretty similar.
Yeah, because it's stimulating. The MRI gives you information because it differentiates cellular activity by motion, the resonance,
right,
the movement of the minerals. And so you can differentiate tissue based on their components. It would be effectively the same thing. You're stimulating the motion at the cellular level.
That's correct.
Would it be more even than microwaving, which develops core heat?
Yes. It's much more even. It gives you a lot of benefits of cooking with gas because it's instant on, instant off, instant up, instant down. It simmers really well. It is very cool. The only thing that gets hot is the pot. You can boil water sitting on a $100 bill.
The pot gets hot. It's not directly affecting the food inside.
The magnetic energy is. The area around the cooktop does not get hot. But since there's no heat generated by the cooktop itself, mm-hmm, is why you can boil that water sitting on a $100 bill.
Yeah, but we're talking about the drawbacks to it. You can't use anything that a magnet won't stick to, so you can't use glass. You can't use any type of Corningware products.
All the old aluminum pots that gave us all Alzheimer's.
All the new aluminum pots that you're out with.
Are they back out?
Well, no. Does
copper magnet stick to a Revereware copper bottom pots? Does magnet stick to copper?
No.
I'd have to go around the house with a magnet then.
You do, and there are... There are some premium manufacturers of cookware that that I've noticed in some of the specialty shops now that have little stickers on them that tell you that they will operate on a magnetic induction range.
And all the old cast iron will.
All the old cast iron works perfect.
Drag it out of a drawer.
Yeah, if you can find it and clean all the rust off of it, you know.
Well, no, that's fascinating. Somebody that we had just talked to said she had one and took the pot off and then put her hand on it.
Mm-hmm.
My sister did the same thing long ago in one of the old coils. She still has coils burned in the palm of her hand.
Yeah, she wasn't paying attention and
put her hand down on the burner to reach over it. That sounds like such a great thing to have around when there's kids in a household.
Yeah.
What about, are there any other new technologies as far as the cooktops? I mean,
that's our latest and greatest.
They don't have sensors on the other ones to tell you when the food's ready or anything like that?
Not anymore.
Not anymore. What do you mean, they used to?
There's those burners with a brain that had the little sensor.
Yeah, that
burned out the brain on it.
Burned out the brain, that's right.
So one of the disadvantages of the induction type units, or several of them, no glassware, no aluminum cook pot. You said that also probably cost was pretty high up there because of all the
electronics. You've got a lot of electronics, and
but the real big positive is that you're not going to burn.
Well,
and kids get into things,
right?
Well, and I think that's wonderful.
That's how they learn. It's hot,
and if you leave the burner on and take your pot off, the heat source stops.
I think that's wonderful.
Oh, I think it's great.
That outweighs all the other negatives, having that safety factor. The other thing that I wanted to ask about, too, quickly, is since we're surrounded by gas wells, is that anybody out here have natural gas, or are we all on propane? When can we tap into this natural gas, and what does it do to our appliances? If you have a gas appliance, how much of the natural gas can be adapted to the appliances, or can you make everything function off of the gas?
Yeah, everything. I mean, you've got your heating system.
But
you got
this
your
is
water
the man
heater.
With the whiz bang stuff.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's same. Basically,
same
operates the same principle. The only thing you're changing on your propane is your jets.
Yeah, the orifices will change, and the pressure is a little bit different. So there's an adjustment has to be made to the pressure regulator.
Are there any things that I can't run on gas?
It's designed for gas.
No, everything will. It's
well,
you can have a gas
you got run gas
kitchen.
Refrigerators, gas ovens, no. Gas.
I don't know of any gas refrigerators
anymore. They've gone off. I know they.
What
used
about
to
a microwave? That wouldn't be. That's
no,
not logical.
No, that wouldn't be. No. Dishwasher wouldn't be. So maybe okay. You're going to be. Today you're going to be concerned with what's available in gas is going to be something that will produce heat.
All right. So you
cooking,
can you still have a gas dryer.
Still have a gas dryer.
And the ovens and stovetops.
Ovens.
And the finer chefs have always preferred gas because it's absolutely...
For cooktops. A lot of them now are preferring more along the electric lines for ovens because they're a little more even.
Well, your electric ovens are larger, too. Your gas ovens are a little smaller.
Because? Yeah.
I don't know why.
Why? Why would a gas oven be smaller? Oh, you who manufacture. Okay, one for my team.
Anyway, we're going to have to wrap it up for this week.
That's too bad. I want to. There's so many new and exciting things out there. Yeah. I'm so glad you came.
Going to have to make a bunch of money to afford the new appliances here. Thank you, Al, for being on our show this week. Gene,
thank you.
You too.
And
thank
Gary,
you
it's good to see
up.
You.
Gary,
and everybody can go to Alamo Appliance and get all these whiz-bang new things.
All right. We'll see you next week.